What's going on there, viewers? This is Lazzers, back again with another video, and today I'll be answering one simple question. Can you beat the Callisto protocol only using the grip? Now, if you're as curious as I was when I thought about this challenge, stick around and find out if I'm successful or not. And if this is your first time visiting my channel, feel free to hit that subscribe button for more challenge videos. I plan on doing more challenge videos like this in the future, on video games such as the Dead Space remake and possibly the Resident Evil 4 remake. So stick around for those. And now, without further ado, let's take a look at the rules. Alrighty then. I am not allowed to use any type of firearm whatsoever. I am not allowed to use the baton, or excuse me, the baton. I was saying that word wrong for some reason in the last video. I can only use the grip. Nothing else and nothing more. And of course, I will be using the shiv for this run. And I will be playing on minimum security mode. Only because on maximum security mode, it would be super tedious because of the amount of health they have. Alrighty. With our firearms put away and our batons put away, get ready, ladies and gentlemen, because it's showtime. Now, I think it would be best for this challenge if I started off where I first get the grip. Because if I started off in the beginning, this challenge would end as soon as I meet up with the first infected. And yeah, see, that wouldn't be fun.
3, 2, 1, go!
Now, my very first official hurdle in this challenge was the infirmary. And how will I deal with the 10 or so infected that spawns in there? Now, I think this is a good time for me to dive deeper into the grip for those that don't know or never played this game. You see, the grip has the damage output of a toddler, and yeah, it sucks in the beginning. And also, only have a certain amount of uses for the grip before it's fully depleted. After that, I would have to sit there and wait for it to recharge. And at that point, I'm pretty much just staring at the enemies until, you know, I can use it again. And I would have to admit, this part did give me a bit of trouble because I did try throwing a bunch of objects at him and that wasn't working. And I also tried shoving him up against the wall and that wasn't working because, like I said, the damage sucks. However, I did make a discovery. And just like that, what I thought would be the largest hurdle for me became a cakewalk. Once I cleared an infirmary, it was time for me to sell all my valuable items and upgrade my grip. And once I was done, it was time to make the journey to the shoe. And that journey was actually pretty easy to get through because there were so many level hazards I could just throw enemies into. Even propane tanks I could use to quickly dispatch enemies. And these enemy encounters would continue to get easy as soon as I reached the shoe. Because you see, inside the shoe, it's just littered with these level hazards. That even sometimes, the enemy AI will be clumsy enough to get itself killed. After clearing the shoe, it was time to head down to the sewers. Which, annoyingly enough, there's a bunch of these little slug monsters that just wanted to eat my nipples. And to be honest, I absolutely hate this beginning part. Well, other than that, this run was going pretty smoothly. A little too smooth. Until I met up with him. I call this guy Poopman Frank. Well, let's just call him Frank for short. You see, Frank caught me off guard the first time. And even poor Jacob is still traumatized, getting his head shoved in a pool of poop. Honestly, I really hope somebody sees this and captions this, because I would love to see what people come up with. So what makes Frank a boss fight for me? Well, you see, this area has no level hazards, and with me only using the grip, that means I would have to shove Frank into the wall about maybe over 15 times. And after shoving him up against every single pipe in this room, I was finally victorious. And with Frank out of the way, I was able to turn the valve and make my exit. After a while, I came across another forge. I tried to upgrade my grip, but I was just a little too short on the cash. But you see, that didn't matter, because this next part was actually pretty easy. All I had to do was just throw him off this railing and just banish him off into the Shadow Realm. Tentacle monsters in your way? Just box them to death. Creepy crawlies coming after you? Just relocate them. Enemies blocking your way in a tightly dim-lit corridor? Just bring them the propane. Now, I did get a little bummed out at this part, only because Robo Senpai would not notice me. For some reason, this robot was so good at dodging my attacks, I couldn't believe it. I don't know if it was because I sucked. That totally couldn't be it, right? But eventually, I finally got his attention, and I was able to take him down and take his loot. I honestly was so dumbfounded that I was able to even make it this far, only using the grip. It was amazing to me. I had already proved that I'm capable enough of dealing with the smaller enemies. But I know what you're thinking. What about the boss fights? Well, you see... the platform two-head, I had to cheese because there were no objects I could pick up and throw at him. And for those that don't understand what's happening here, you could basically just keep dodging two-head's attack until he eventually just falls off or just dies on the platform. What about the colony two-head? Well, I tried fighting him legit by just throwing objects at him, and it works. It actually does pretty okay damage. But then, Mr. Two-Head caught me off guard and killed me. And you see, I've been doing this for like 20 minutes because launching objects at him does little damage, even on easy mode. So, I cheesed him too. I didn't feel like going through all that again. Now, Ferris, I had to fight him legit. There was no cheesing him at all. But his arena did give me plenty of objects to throw at him. So, that's what I did until he got pissed off and decided to throw me towards Danny. In the server two-head? Well, there wasn't any cheesing strategies for him. However, I did try to bring some objects in with me so I can launch them at him. However, they end up disappearing in the doorway. Like, I don't know what the cause of that was. Maybe it's aliens. But yeah, unfortunately, this is where the run truly ends. I had to use weapons to even make it past the server room two-head. So that, unfortunately, will be a weapon use for me. And even if I was able to get past the server room two-head, I had Ferris to worry about again. You see, his arena has no objects I could pick up and throw at him, because they're outside of the arena. And I tried everything. I tried glitching items through the wall, and I couldn't find anything. So I had to use weapons just to kill this guy, or beat him. And when Ferris finally entered his second form, it was pretty much a game of patience there. All I had to do was just sit there and keep launching this tiny box at him and whatever else I could grab and throw at him inside the arena. And after a few short minutes, Ferris went down and the credits rolled. And ladies and gentlemen, if you made it this far into the video, I highly appreciate it. If you like what you saw, let me know down in the comment section below. And if you wish to see more content like this, feel free to subscribe. There's currently other games that I plan on making videos about, so stay tuned for that. And with that, ladies and gentlemen, this is Lazzers, signing off.